So all kind of letter writing, what kinds of business letters we have. Your and that is your letter of complaint, letter of inquiry, seeking information, giving information, placing an order. All these letters we will be discussing. So that means for class 11, there is a lot of syllabus. So you have to put in efforts in English also. And considering the changed format that we might have, I will have to share multiple choice questions also with you all for your practice. Okay? Right? Or when we have an online session or when everyone is online, so when I can share that time also, we can have during the revision days. But first, we have to finish the syllabus. So, okay, quick look at the poem Laburnum Top for the benefit of those who are absent. And of course, yes, I just need to discuss a few things again. So let's have a look at it, please. And how many students are present today? 24, and I have 14 students offline. And as I said, this is your standard strength, right? Yes. So it's like 38, 39 students. It's more than expected, isn't it? And offline students are also absent. A couple are absent today. Aditya, sit straight. Sit straight. Wear your mask properly. Can I see a book? What are we doing? Which lesson are we doing? Okay, which poem are we doing? Can you read the title for me? Can you read the title for me? Why not? What is funny? Even better, Aditya, will you read the poem? Because he does not know. He's never tried. I am not doing reading lessons in the class that you were absolutely missed it. This is something that you're supposed to do. And you should know. And if this is what you're coming to class for, to create disturbance and to talk to others, then I think so you're making a big mistake. Right? Yes, anybody tell me, yeah, online, offline, what is this poem about? What about the Laburnum Top? How does it appear in the September afternoon sunlight? How does it appear? It's silent. The tree is silent. When does the tree come alive? It appears as if the tree has come alive. When the bird, yes, a small bird, the goldfinch, arrives, it makes a lot of noise and it makes the tree come alive. Right? So some many, you know, like there are people who have written that this poem, it also discusses, you can see the relation that is the tree and the bird. And how the tree which appears to be lifeless, the tree which appears to be so silent, right? And lifeless, just like the leaves which are being shed from its branches, right? And when the goldfinch comes, everything comes alive. And here it is, yes, some people would say it is the relationship of the goldfinch and the tree. We can also say that it is also about the goldfinch, how the goldfinch will go again and again, make that tree come alive. Because what is there? What is there in that tree? A nest is there, little birds are there. And yes, the goldfinch will go there again and again to feed the family, right? So yeah, well, what are the things that we have? So I'm just going to discuss it once again hurriedly. Now this poem, it is about this laburnum top, and it is silent and still in the September afternoon sunlight. And out of the infinite, very quietly, very quickly, very swiftly, the small bird comes. Quite small, but it has so much of energy, and so much of energy it makes the whole tree comes alive. And it comes and sits on the branch, and then of course very sleekly, very quietly, just enters the thickness of the branches. And yes, there is so much of noise, there is so much of movement. And that noise and that movement is there, the little bird so excited to see their mother, right? And yes, making that noise and making that movement. And after the goldfinch is satisfied that she has fed her young ones, she comes and sits at the end of the branch. And that is when we see her identity. Right? So she's hiding behind those, you can say, the branches. And she's a golden color bird with stripes on the face, right? And after that, very quietly, or you can say just like it came, very swiftly and silently, the little bird flies once again into the infinite. It launches, takes off, goes away. And as it flies away, it makes this very strange whistling sound, which is characteristic of that bird. But in that silence, it gives that strangeness. And yes, it seems as once again, the tree has become silent, although there is life there. The tree has life. The little birds over there. But they only come alive when the goldfinch will come back again, right? So there are a lot of words in this poem. There are words which show movement. There are words which show sound. So those of you who have books, and yes, even at home when you can see the screen, let us start here. Look at this line. Till the goldfinch comes. Nalini, look at your book, please. With a twitching chirrup. With a twitching chirrup. Yes, Suyash, look at your book. Which one of the, I'm not asking you to literally just look at your book. Look at your book means? Look at the words written over there. Read them. Try to understand them. Fir hum kahenge, ma'am, hame reading nahi aati hai. And you're in class 11. Should I send you back to your KG classes again? Okay, very nice. So, right, come on. Twitching chirrup. Which one is a sound and which is a movement? Chirrup is sound and twitching is a movement. Okay, very nice. Suddenness, startlement. Sound words? Yes. Sudden, startle, all of a sudden, you know, like how it comes and sits at the branch and all of a sudden, right? Abruptly. Sleek as a lizard. Sleek as a lizard. It's a simile. The movement of the bird has been compared to the silent, quick movement of the lizard. So sleek as a lizard, what is it? Is it a sound word or is it a movement? It's a movement, yes, so write a silent movement. Alert and abrupt. Alert and abrupt. Movement, very good, very good. She enters the thickness and a machine starts up. This is the line that I want to discuss again. She enters the thickness. Who is she over here? Goldfinch, very good, very nice. Thickness, thickness is the top of the tree, the branches of the laburnum top. And a machine starts. Like when you start a machine, right? Of course, like, yeah, so there has to be some kind of way in which it starts, right? So what is the machine here? What is the machine that has started? The family there, it has started making that noise, right? Because on the arrival of the goldfinch, right? Chitterings and of tremor of wings and trillings. Chittering, is it a sound word or is it a, it's a sound, chittering, the sound which is made by the little bird. Tremor of wings. So we have a big hint along with it. Wings, tremor, movement, right? So all that shaking movement, it's sound all happening together. So just imagine how much of life there, how much of energy, how much of activity happening in the tree, right? So much of excitement the little ones have to see their mother, right? And just like maybe when your parents, they come back from the market and you're so excited to see what have they got for you. Yeah, right? So the little birds are very excited to see their mother. They're hungry. They're waiting for the grub that she has brought. And a machine starts up. of chitterings and of tremor of wings and trillings. What do you think is trillings? Sound. Yes, yes, yes. Right. Absolutely right, Isha. Absolutely correct. The whole tree trembles and thrills. I hope you're noting down in your books. Can I see you writing? What a wonderful sight it would be. After so many days and months and seeing my students writing in front of me. So it's a very long awaited sight. Right, Deepak? Yeah, he's still not writing. I'm talking since then. The whole tree trembles and thrills. Whole tree trembles. It seems that the tree has come alive. Right? Trembling and thrilling. Thrill is that excitement. It's movement. Yes. So is there any other device over here? What can we say? The tree is there, right? It's coming alive. It has life also, but it is showing a lot of movement also. Personification, can we? Yes, absolutely correct. It is the engine of her family. Now, this is one line that I would like to discuss again. What is the engine? If the family is the machine, right? Engine bird, you know? Yeah. Which bird? Goldfinch. Very right. And please do remember this. It is the engine of her family. So the little bird is the engine, and the engine is there giving all the fuel to the rest of the machine. Keeps it working. So this little bird, tiny bird, is so much alive, is so much of active, so much of energized, and it is giving life, or it is giving that energy to the rest of the family. Stokes it full. She stokes it full. So, right, yeah, just like you have, you know, the furnaces, they have to be stoked full. That coal has to be put again and again so that it keeps on functioning. Stokes it full, feeds it full. Because it's an engine, because it's a family. The little mouths that need to be fed, okay? So she stokes it full, then flirts out to a branch end, movement. After she's happy, satisfied, my family is fed. Once again, the little bird comes and sits at the end of the branch. So that flirting there. So now she's come. And now she's showing her identity. Otherwise, when she entered the, you know, thickness of the laburnum top, we were not even aware. What happened? When did we realize that this little bird has come? Or there is some movement there. When the whole tree started trembling and, you know, trills and chirping and all that. Now we notice the appearance of the little bird. So she stokes it full and flirts out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. When you will refer, or you will find here, there is something that we have discussed. Transferred epithet. Do you remember what is a transferred epithet? Any one of you? Full marks to that child. Yes, Isha has identified it correctly. Yes, what is a transferred epithet? So it is generally, you know, like, yes, the quality of living, right? Or that quality has been transferred to something else, right? So here it is showing a barred face identity mask. What are the bars? As I said, both ways you can interpret it, that there are stripes on her face, right? Secondly, she is hiding her face behind the leaves, the branches, the seeds that are hanging from the tree, right? Showing her barred face identity mask, barred behind the what? Leaves, right? Okay, barred face identity mask. So it does appear to be barred because of the, you know, like a barrier there, right? The barrier of the leaves or the seeds, whatever is there, hiding her face. Then with airy, delicate whistle, chirrup, whisperings. Airy, strange. Right? Whistle. Whistle, your whistling sound, right? Yeah, so with delicate whistle. Why is it delicate? Because it's a very small bird. So very softly making that whistling sound. And because of the stillness of the whole surrounding, it makes it appear quite strange, right? Delicate whistle, chirrup, whisperings. What's chirrup? What is a chirrup? The sound made by the bird. Chirruping sound, twittering sound. All these are the sound words, okay? So chirrup, whisperings. She launches away. You launch something. Send something, isn't it? Right? She's gone there. She's taken off towards the infinite. What is infinite here? The sky. So she has gone back to, you know, like, of course, looking for more food and the places, others. And the laburnum subsides to empty. Subside means it returns to empty. Okay. So what happened in the beginning of the poem? What was the laburnum top like in the beginning of the poem? Silent. And at the end of the poem? Silent. Right? And of course, in between, there was a lot of activity. And that activity was because of the goldfinch. Krish, are you listening? Yes? Can you tell me the name of the bird that comes to the laburnum top? Golden finch. Okay, it's goldfinch. Thank God he didn't say goldfish. Anything can happen here. Okay, we have magic happening, right? We're talking about eerie whistle, chirping. So we might be having some other supernatural elements happening, okay? And the laburnum subsides to empty. Just like, you know, the milk, it comes to a boil all of a sudden. And you wonder, oh my God. What? But then it subsides. So just like this, all of this activity has happened. And once again, the laburnum has come back to its silence. Now, a quick, of course, a recap or a recall. You're going to tell me, what did you think is the dominant color in this poem? Yellow. What all are the yellow things here? So yellow, the laburnum top. Yes, the flowers, which are there. Are the flowers there on the tree? Are they? Yes, yes, but they're being shed, isn't it? In the few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. The leaves are also falling. What do you think is there, the color of the leaves now? As they're being shed. So from a green, they change into that orange and yellows and browns, the color of autumn, isn't it? Yes. Then the yellow of the afternoon sunlight. Very good. As it reflects or as it falls. That is what I'm asking you. That's what I'm asking you. Where is that yellow? You people are saying. Leaves are there. Laburnum top, we know it has beautiful yellow flowers. But flowers will not be there because which season is it? Which season is it? Autumn. Autumn mein flowers ko kya ho jata? The to, okay, fine. The. Okay, fine, fine. Any argument that you give is acceptable as long as it is a reasonable and a justified one. Here it is, of course, here, yeah, because it's a laburnum top. And what is one thing very characteristic about the laburnum top? The yellow flowers, right? So we have the flowers which were there once. Now the leaves are also being shed because it is autumn. And the light, the sunlight reflected, as he said. So the golden color is there dominating. And of course, many people talk about that it is a kind of a, you know, like a symbiotic relationship between the bird and the tree. Right? Okay. So it is a kind of a give and take. If you remember what you had done, maybe you've run these words and remember what it means. Okay. Is there any rhyme scheme? Still, light, fallen, chirrup, and abrupt. No, there is no rhyme scheme. But even then, it does convey that kind of a poetic feel to it. Right? Because of a lot of sound words have been used. Movement words to bringing out that energy, bringing out that momentum, which gives this poem quite a nice feel. Okay. Any doubts, any questions, any one of you? So we have simile, right? We have metaphor. You've done personification. We've done transferred epithets. Yes, alliteration also. Okay. Your assonance. So all these devices you have to remember. Okay. So any doubts, any questions? And of course, yes, so your multiple choice questions, that is what you will be having. This time I shared a very, very simple, easy multiple choice question. Next time I'm going to change a little bit. Of course, it will be multiple choice, but the questions I will now make more of reasoning and understanding, right? So let us change a few questions, right? So I'd asked one or two questions about your writing skills also. What is the minimum word limit of notice? 50. And if I say maximum? No, you have 5 words more. That is it. You're supposed to write 50 and you end up writing 80. Are you going to get marks for it? No, in general it is generally 52. 5 words more here and there are acceptable, right? Okay. Then, of course, the thing which is not required when you write the format of the notice. Time is not mentioned. You have the date, isn't it? You need the heading, your name of the institution. We don't need day also. So day and time is there when you write your diary entries, not in the notice. Okay. Rest, any other doubts, any question which that was not clear to you all? Oh, ma'am, online, you're very intelligent. You ask us questions. Any question you ask us, we have the answer. Isn't it? We are so confident. So forget about discovering TERT, which offline students were never able to understand. We have a special form of intelligence. Gifted with it. Since 2020. Isn't it? Pehle thi use nahi ki thi. Oh my God. This the Google Forms made us discover it. It was, we need a Howard Carter to discover that intelligence of yours. Do we? Right, we need a Howard Carter to discover it. Anyway, nice that you are blessed with so much of intelligence. It's a nice thing to know. Okay, yes, here. Now, students, let's come on to the next part. Tomorrow, I'm going to continue with the next chapter, that is Landscape of the Soul. Because you people remember everything that we have done in our earlier classes, let us just go through the we have notice writing. Yes? What are my intelligent students saying? Any doubts? Purav is there in the class? So we have letter and we have speech. So what kind of letters we have? You can see your letter of inquiry, right? You are seeking information as well as you have your letter of and you have placing an order. Okay. That is, there is a little doubt regarding that. Whatever our school exams are going to be, what is conducted in the school, we are going to give subjective questions also. At least your writing skills are going to be there. Writing skills to hai. 3 marks notice and your, I think so, 5 marks letter. 40 marks test is going to be. No format, no separate marks. Yeah. Okay. Right. So you please here. Yeah, Harleen, you have any doubts, any questions? No doubts at all. So these are the things that we need to. This is speech, I think. So we have done notice, we have done. Now we will be focusing on the letter writing. Okay. Yes. Done. Yeah, these are 3 letters of which we have been discussing, I think, so in class 9th, also in class 10th, also we have done. Now we'll be doing them again. What are the things here? Okay, right here. Yes. What is Kunal saying? Yes, inquiry, letter of inquiry is seeking information. And that information, it could be about a course, it could be about any product, it could be about any service, right? Okay, now if you have to ask about here, you know, you want to seek information about a course, what kind of queries, you know, like after your introduction part, you will have to ask questions, which are their queries related to the information that you seek. So you want to do, say, a course in creative writing, right? What would your queries be? So it's an online course for creative writing and you're writing a letter. What all queries will you have about the course? Basic queries, what do you think about any course would be? Come on, hurry up, tell me. Yes. The cost, okay. About the duration also, you will know. Okay, certificate, naturally you will be getting if you're doing that course, if you complete it. Right? So you have to decide. It is for your betterment. It is for your, you can say, growth that you are doing this course. So if you just want a certificate or you really actually want to learn. You want to learn, right? And you want the certificate also. So why is it, you know, like we take things the easy way out. Why do we always assume that, okay, these things are like that only? So if we have that kind of a positivity, you know, only then we will go with some kind of expectations. And remember here, whenever we decide to do any kind of course, so after your 12th or whenever here, please do check the credentials, check the validity, right? See that is this course valid elsewhere? I've got a certificate, I've put my hard-earned money, I put time and effort into it. Is it going to be valid, right? Are other universities going to recognize it? So these are things which we need to keep in mind. So when we are registering ourselves or when we opt to do any kind of work, you have to be very, very alert. So your internet is not only here, you know, for your social media, you must use it for enhancing your knowledge also, for broadening your horizons. Right? So when it comes about seeking information, otherwise we have so many queries, but these are the queries which are actually very, very relevant. And then when it comes to that, of course, we need to identify which is true and which could be a fake kind of a course. You know, some people are there, like he said, yeah, they'll take the money and you'll never hear about that person. You'll never hear about that, you know, place again. So you have to make relevant, you can say, searches and your research about the course that you seek to do, right? And especially when online here, we have a lot of frauds also happening, okay? So we're going to continue with this. And we're starting a very, very difficult, I would say, chapter. That is Landscape of the Soul.